Hi everybody, today we're doing a video all about baby gas. What to do if you find yourself with a screaming child who's kicking their legs, and what foods might be causing it if you're breastfeeding. If you don't know me yet, hi, I'm Katie and I'm a registered holistic nutritionist, the founder of Live It Well Nutrition, and the mama to two little ones right now, under two. So if you haven't yet, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button so that you join us for all the videos that I do on this channel. I post Wednesdays about nutrition, mom life, and natural living, and Saturdays all about my postpartum fitness journey and fitness tips, which also come to you from the personal trainer, Claire Gray, who joined us on this project as well. So definitely stick around and join us for those. Okay, so some signs that your baby could be stuck with gas is that they're kicking their legs out at the same time and obviously in discomfort, they're crying. Another sign that's more extreme gas is that their stomach is actually hard and not puffy when you touch it. It's just hard because of all of that built up trapped gas. So that's a good sign to know that your baby actually has gas. So here's what you do. First thing you want to do if your baby is crying with trapped gas is to get a menthol type rub, like a chest rub for coughs. Make extra sure that it's mild because your baby's skin is super sensitive and the vapor will rise up and we don't want to burn their little eyes. I use a baby friendly rub called Natural Menthol Rub. But you can also use coconut oil and a very mild dilution of peppermint oil as well. The point is for the menthol heat to break up the gas into little pockets that are easier to pass, as well as to deliver some comfort to your little one, or at the very least, a distracting sensation. Make sure they don't touch their tummy with their hands, because their hands eventually touch their eyes or their mouth. And as you apply it, you want to rub it in like a rainbow. The reason you want to rub it clockwise or like a rainbow is to follow the natural direction of their intestines. We have the large intestine that, if looking at it, it goes from the bottom left side up across the abdomen and then down the right side to the anus. I have actually put my kids to sleep doing this. After you've rubbed this in, and if your kid isn't asleep, you can also hold them in a position that uses both gravity and brings their knees to their chest. Lastly, I'd also try bicycle kicks, because this will also help to pump those gas pockets out, but I do prefer the upright position because I think it's more effective and comforting for them. Gas could be caused by simply swallowing air, not having a good latch, that sort of thing. But it could also be caused by some of the foods that you're eating in your diet that is transferring to your baby through the breast milk. First of all, let's mention the most common culprit, and that's dairy. Whether it's a mild allergy to the dairy proteins whey or casein, or if it's an intolerance to the milk sugar, lactose, it can all cause gas in your little one. By the way, even some soy cheeses have casein, the milk protein, in their cheese. So make sure to look for the label casein free on the label of your soy cheese. Legumes or grains or nuts and seeds all contain something called phytic acid that can cause gas if you don't soak or sprout the food first. Even canned beans can contain phytic acid, amongst other things, because the way that they actually cook the beans is done while the beans are in the can, and they do this by pressure cooking the can itself. So if you can, and if you're super sensitive, like some people are, without knowing it, then just stay away from the canned beans. If anything, just try to remember to soak your beans overnight and boil them. Watermelon is a common trigger, but there are also plenty of other foods that can cause gas, like cucumber, which ranks as one of the highest gas-causing vegetables because it has a specific gas-causing compound in it. Instead of cutting out all of these foods just in case one of them is causing you gas, I suggest contacting a nutritionist who can help narrow down what's really going on and causing the gas so that you can take out what's necessary and have more nutrition in your milk supply and for yourself when you are going about your eating. I am one such nutritionist who would be happy to help you. If you contact me, I will leave the information in the description below for you. I really hope that you enjoyed this video, and I definitely hope that you found it helpful, and that your little one, if having gas, passes it and is comfortable once again. If you did like this video, please take a moment and hit that subscribe button so that you don't miss more videos with me. As I said before, I post Wednesdays and Saturdays and all throughout the month of December in bonus Christmas themed videos. So be sure not to miss those. In the meantime, live it well, because you only live once. Bye.